involved to come to their functions. And I'm kind of preaching to the choir because the parents who are here are clearly the involved parents, and I want to commend you on that. But coming to their functions, coming to the sports day, coming to their concerts, showing up, being present. And we want to be connected, not just by being physically present, but being aware, being conscious. When we're driving in the car, are we connected? There's opportunity when you're driving to talk with your children, to ask them, you know, how was your day? Tell me about your day. Not just what you did, because often we say, what did you do today? I did math, I did English, and we had PE. But how was your day? Tell me about your day. How was it for you? So they can learn to share their feelings. We need to be involved with us being able to express our feelings to our children and helping them when they, because especially when they're little, they don't have the words, they don't even know what they're feeling. So they will act out, they will throw tantrums, they will, you know, hit. We teach, we can say to them, you're really, really upset because Johnny broke your toy. Or you're really upset because Kimberly's not speaking with you right now. And it's really hard because she's your best friend. And then you talk with them about how they feel, and you talk with them about how to solve that. Talking with them, not just to them, so that they can learn. So they come, so by the time they get to adolescence, and they're even more independent, and they're starting to forge their own identity. Some of you are parents of 11 and 12 year olds, preteens. If you have built that relationship with them throughout, then they'll be more likely when they are ready to speak with you. But if there's not been that connection and that involvement all along, and suddenly we're trying to forge it, then suddenly we want to ask about what's going on, often they will put up the wall. So we want to build that all the way through. The other thing I wanted to talk about in terms of involvement is about the technology. Ms. Abadik talked about how the phone connects through the internet, or the smartphone, the tablet, the computers, and we're connected in so many ways. We have hundreds and hundreds of channels on cable, and we have internet that connects them to the world. This worldwide web of who knows what. There's great things, and there are other things that we don't want connected with our children. We need to be involved. We need to know what they're watching. We need to learn how to use those parental controls. How to use the timers that stop the television from coming on without a password at certain times or certain programs, so that we can monitor, even sometimes when we're not there, what's happening with our children and what they're being exposed to. I was talking with a parent yesterday, and she was really concerned, and it's something that I have been concerned about with the kids. Because what was happening is that her child has this attitude. Very early child, bright child, more mature for her years, but she is gravitating towards these programs on TV with the teenagers and the mean girls and the cool kids. And have you ever noticed that the parents are absent many times in these shows? Or if they're present, they don't have any sense, the kids know everything. And so the children are watching these things, and these are children's programs, right? And the wrong values are being, they're learning from what they see. Even the little ones, they learn from the cartoon characters. They learn from the Power Rangers and all of these little things. And is what they're learning, does it line up with the values and the character that you want your children to develop as they grow? You need to watch them. You need to know what's on. Sometimes there's opportunity to watch with them and then to talk about what you're seeing so that they can learn how to make good choices, how to make decisions, how to weigh things, how to not just accept it because it's there, but how to question it and think, you know, is this the right thing to do? And in being involved, again, when it comes to the internet, we need to safeguard that as well, because let's say I really discourage parents from having computers in children's rooms with connection to the internet. But now we have all these smartphones. And the smartphones, you know, they can be anywhere. And who knows, you know, they can accidentally or deliberately tap into something that is not appropriate for them or that doesn't represent the values, the moral values we want to instill. So we need to check in. We need to check in with our kids. We need to put in the safeguards and we need to talk with them about those values. Because otherwise we're inviting into our homes and we're inviting into our children's lives the world wide web. You know what happens in spider webs? Does anybody know what spider webs?
Yeah.
Yes, what happens, what do spider webs do? Involved. We've got to talk with them and help them to make good choices. And then when it comes to the academics, we want to support them, and you saw in the little skit. We don't want to do homework for them. We want to ask questions that will help them come up with the answers. And then if they don't understand, we explain. And as they grow older, you know, we don't want to be doing their projects, but we want to support them. We want to ask them what they need. We want to teach them how to plan, right? And we want to teach them responsibility. And even from they're 3 years old and they're making those little choices and things happen, they might make a choice, climb up something you told them not to climb on and they fall and hurt themselves. We don't say, oh, bad down chair, you hurt Mary. No, Mary fell because Mary climbed up, and we can say, oh, you climbed up and you fell. Help them to learn when they make choices. Their responsibility. They're responsible for what they do and then how to correct them. And we do that by communicating, by talking with them, by being present. If we can't be there all the time, many of us are working, so we have maybe the helper or another family member or something, or they're in the daycare. We want to make sure, as far as we possibly can, that what's being instilled, the values line up, the same structure, the same discipline, because children need that consistency. So we want to be involved, coming to school, getting to know your child's teacher, getting to know the daycare people, the aftercare staff. You want to make sure that the people who are in your home are going to be representing and certainly carrying out the same kinds of values and discipline that you stand for. You need to be involved. If we invest our time, if we invest in being connected in that way, then our children will move through those tasks. They will learn to recognize that they have autonomy, they have choice and responsibility. They will learn that they can take initiatives, they can try things. It's okay to try and fail. We want to encourage them to try. If when they make a mistake, we say, what kind of stupidness is that? Why are you going to do that? Such a foolish thing. Or what are you doing now? We kind of shut it down. We don't want to shame them. We don't want them to feel incapable or bad, that they are bad. What we want is for them to know, I did something wrong, if they did something morally wrong, and that there's a consequence. We want them to understand, I made a mistake, but I can try again another way. Or I tried this thing and I just know that that's not for me, I'm not so great at that. We want to encourage that. We want to encourage them to try. We want to encourage children to be able to try and answer things, even if they make a mistake. We can say, that was a good try. And then we help them learn what the correct answer is. As parents, we need to be involved in that. We want our children to know that, yes, they have things that they're great at, they have interests, and we want to affirm that so that how they see themselves and how they feel about themselves is healthy. We don't want children who think they're better than everybody else, everything they do is perfect. Neither do we want children who feel like, you know, I can't try because I'm going to make a mistake. So we want to encourage them to build that healthy self-concept, healthy idea of who they are, and healthy self-esteem. That isn't thinking they're better than other people, but at the same time, they don't think that they're worse than other people. And we want to foster healthy competition. So again, we get involved in their activities, and we don't compare. What did so-and-so get in the test? Or when your brother was in that grade, he was getting all 90s and you're only getting 70s. We want to encourage their effort, not to compare. We want them to compete with themselves to be better and better and better, and to praise the effort that they make in doing that. And so, again, I just want to go back to what it says in Psalm 127. Children are the inheritance of the Lord. Not our jobs, not our houses, not any of those things. Although, as Mr. Niche, financial services said, we want healthy financial management, because that's important. But understand that the most important thing are our children. We want to invest our time, our energy, our effort. We want to set good examples. We want to be connected with them. We want to encourage them. And we want to be involved and build relationship with them so that they know, they always know they have you. They always know they have someone, some base to come back to no matter what. Because no matter how old they become, if they become as old as I am, they will know that they are loved, they will know that they are valued, and they will know that there's someone they can go to when they mess up, who's going to listen, who's going to help them to think it through and sort it out, who's going to encourage them so that they can grow and indeed discover and take their rightful role in society and in making this world a better place. Thank you for having me. And again, I wish you a wonderful day. I don't think there's much left of the seminar, but take all the little nuggets. Not everything is going to be for everyone, but take those choice morsels that apply to you and give some time to your kids.